required to turn 170 in. Between George Hussain and Emil Rastati, who is a champion jockey, it was Patrick's idea to have a South Caribbean Jockeys Championship between Barbadian and Hanfran.
Competition.
7-year-old Gildy by freshly squeezed out of the best familiar Northern Firm. Owned by Captain David Oshar, spread by fellow CB pilot John O'Brien, Chanticleer's earned over $675,000 in his illustrious career. This is a noteworthy performance. The Chanticleer carried 58.5 kilos and gave away 5 kilos to the younger infallibility, leaving 4 to the rest of the field.
This is probably the most special victory for the JTP. We broke the record today. And it's not really close to this record, but it's just going on the wrong. It's quite a nice time, and we just enjoy him. But we don't know, I don't know if I'll ever get something like this again. We're all very happy. He's done a lot to promote racing. In fact, he's destroyed all the foreign invasion that he's been around for the last 3-4 years. This is true. In recent times, the last couple of months, he has had some conditions. Like I'm going this morning there. And we only raced him today in 6 Colombo without big waves, so we continue. He was in tip-top condition. He was pulled in any condition. And we just gave him a chance because he damaged himself and he stabled it. But this is very special. 18 wins now with 58.5 kilos. He pulls all the pedals to the in the centralized track. So that's actually two records he has broken today.
Many people felt that he would not be able to catch infallibility.
I think, you know, in the last race, safe to say, you know, beating him by a length, giving him 2 kilos and man when he ride, and he was so yes. But he was a little better for this race than the last race. He was needed around the last time on time. When he worked Monday morning, I felt very confident. Well, we'll take the grandstand, as they say.
Look, he didn't want us to lose the tour when they called him with the tour to be the marker.
He really is tough. It's a pleasure to be around someone of that nature. And I don't know if we'll ever get, I'll ever get another one like it in my lifetime. But so, I can't, words can't say how nice it is to have a horse of that nature.
Well, he's running out of opponents. That's the main worry now.
Well, you know, that's it. This year they're bringing a lot of horses from America. It's going to be interesting because, as I said, they're bringing a lot of them from Kentucky, but he was bred just across the road in Carapu, and he might send them back. I don't know. But that's what racing is all about, and God is going to bring the crowds, and I think we'll have a good year.
In other views pertaining to the sport of racing, and in particular the West Indian Thoroughbred Racing Association, many owners of stallions in the three major territories have come out in their numbers to support the regional breeding industry and the 2004 West Indian Classic. Racing Secretary Derek Cozier tells us more.
Conclusive nominations on January 31st, we got 59 stallions nominated, which was very good. Actually, our projection from Barbados has been now materialized. Disappointed with Jamaica, but we are assured that of these stallions that are nominated, they will probably capture these polo winners. It's a start, and I'm very confident that this is the way that we will move, and hopefully over the next 3 years, I know we will be sufficient funds. The 21st Future Classic, under this new format, is one of the 2004. We will achieve our, you know, goals money-wise and everything.
Racing Secretary Derek Cozier. Our final event in today's program is the Whitford Stallion Stakes for horses bred in Trinidad and Tobago. This 35th-meter extended sprint brought out all the leading three-year-olds in the country. The top two-year-olds of last year, the leading colt Mountain Dance and the gallant filly New Millennium, along with the improving runners, Towers, Pete Janton, Puntua Punto. That's Puntua Punto bringing their mom to the main course, the leader from Her Majesty, King of Siam, well there, New Millennium, Witchcraft and Towers, which missed the break as race run into contention, making them lost ground to challenge for the lead, and Powers along the inside rail will take over from Puntua Punto, followed by New Millennium in the orange silk third, King of Fire in fourth, followed by Witchcraft and Peace Chant in the pink. Her Majesty comes next, the gap to Genitive Light, and the slow starting runner Bookbound to Dance with a lot of work to do as Powers have been vigorously written by, of course, his rider Ragunath, but now being collared by Brian Harding on Puntua Punto on the far side. New Millennium, the filly, is game, and she's right there in second, but it's Puntua Punto racing to the home turn and 400 metres to go, and Brian Harding says go on Puntua Punto, leads them into the stretch from New Millennium. Peace Chant is bound to dance with a mountain to climb. He's very wide and 8 lengths off the pace of Puntua Punto. Down the stretch, then race, and it's Puntua Punto, 3 lengths to the cliff. The filly is New Millennium and Peace Chant. Majesty, and here comes aboard 124-1. A fine performance indeed from Punto a Punto, another bargain party for Trina Douglas Bennett and his partner for just $16,000 at the yearling sales last year. This round cut by research into now earned close to $100,000 in just 7 career starts. His fourth win in the hands of Brian Harding. He's celebrated decisively at the head of the stretch to hold the determined charge of the Philly New Millennium, with Bantam Dance staying on after being slowly away back stumbling at the off with Towers. The fractions were 24-3, 48, 113-3 and 124-1. And so it's on to the first classic of the season, the Home Construction Guineas on April 24th, over 1,800 metres. Lots of classic racing around the Caribbean coming up next month, as mentioned earlier. The Barbados Guineas will be run on April 1st, the same date as the first classics in Jamaica. The 1,000 guineas for fillies and the 2,000 for colts and geldings. Both events will be run over 1,600 metres at Camanas Racecourse in St. Catherine, Jamaica. And you can find out more about Jamaican racing by visiting their website at www.ultraquest.com. For more on that, here's Paul Lowe, systems consultant at Camanas Racecourse.
The website came about in 1997, where Chris Harman and myself got together and we decided we would try to put something on the internet for Camanas Park Racing. And basically that's how it started. And over the last 2 years, we have been growing in terms of putting up the program, past performances, results, things like that.
It's very comprehensive.
Yes, and we try to make it timeless so that people would not wait too long to get the information.
What is the feedback you've received from racing fans here in Jamaica and the other islands of the Caribbean?
Actually, it's been quite good because a lot of people really didn't think that we'd get to that stage so soon. And I think they are really glad that they don't need to come here to get information. They can stay at home and really get all the information they need, especially when they are not in Jamaica.
You're doing a fabulous job promoting racing in Jamaica. I met a fellow who told me that he picked up the website. He was in Europe and he wanted to know what was happening at Camanas. That must be good news for you.
Yes, it is. And actually, we do a lot of PR in the sense that there was a trainer. Well, last week, her daughter contacted me. She lives in Hong Kong, and she wanted to find her mom. And we located Gloria Castillo for
her. So what plans have you got for the website and for developing it?
Well, what we want to do eventually is get into live racing from Camanas Park, as well as online betting, hopefully. Because a lot of people have been sending emails asking about online betting.
Thank you very much, Paul Lowe, systems consultant at Camanas Racecourse. Once again, their website, www.ultraquest.com. On next month's program, we'll be focusing on the guineas in Jamaica and in Barbados, so you won't want to miss that. As we go, we extend our thanks to the Sandy Beach Island Resort in Barbados, as well as the Barbados Turf Club for making this program possible. Take care. See you next time around for more top-class West Indian thoroughbred racing.